I, 32 male, have been living in DB for 1 year and just discovered my wife, 31 female, is having an affair, part 3. Update 1. The last 5 days have felt like a Category 6 storm. But with the aid of fantastic friends, family, co-workers, supervisors, and you fellow Redditors, I've pulled myself together and arranged everything to go tomorrow. I discovered that I am blessed to be surrounded by great and supportive individuals who have assisted me in navigating through this chaos. I've become even closer to my family and friends, and I've realized that in the 10 years I've been with her, I've lost touch with some wonderful individuals with whom I'd want to reconnect. I've shifted my emphasis from wanting to learn more about them and what they did bar doing to not caring about her and doing the things and being with people that make me happy and bring me pleasure. I'll leave her tomorrow and carry all of my belongings with me. My lawyer will call her at the end of the day and I will then discontinue all communication with her and her family. I doubt she'll attempt to attend my friend's wedding by herself, and even if she does, she won't be welcomed. I'd want to thank everyone again for their encouragement, advice, and recommendations on what I should do, as well as everyone who disputed my judgments and points of view with their own thoughts and reasons. Thank you to everyone who shared their stories and offered me hope for the future when I couldn't find it. Thank you very much. Best wishes. Update 2. Everything went swimmingly. After my soon-to-be ex-wife departed for work, 4 members of my family came at my house, and we began packing my belongings and loading the vehicles with my belongings. We packed everything in approximately 4 hours, took many photographs of how we left things, and then I departed and shut the door for good. As recommended by the lawyer, I left the keys I'd been using for the last 3 years inside the home, and when I shut the door, I felt liberated and glad to be able to go. We enjoyed a delicious meal and toasted my escape and newly discovered freedom. In the afternoon, I canceled all of my credit cards, went to counseling, and felt great about myself. I phoned my friends who were getting married the following day and informed them what had occurred and that I would be attending their wedding alone, and they were very supportive of my choice. I also informed the rest of our tight circle of friends, who were astounded by what I had gone through and were very supportive. My soon-to-be ex-wife, there should be an abbreviation for this, P texted me at the end of the day to say she was leaving work to go home, just a reminder that she believed that we would go to my parents' home on that day to attend my friend's wedding on the weekend. I waited approximately 40-50 minutes, the time I expected her to return home. Before texting her what my lawyer had directed me to do, I got out of the house. You're well aware of what you've been up to. We'll start the divorce procedure next week. I phoned her mother immediately after sending that text and essentially told her the same thing, that I had left the home, that I would start the divorce process after the weekend, and that her daughter understands what she's been doing, and that she would explain what she feels she has to explain. She asked that I give her my version, but I refused since I didn't want to speak negatively about her daughter and would rather that she explain what she believes she has to explain. I could give my side later, but I didn't want to do it right now. I couldn't tell whether her mother knew anything about her daughter's cheating activities from our little conversation, and to be honest, I don't care. That moment, breaking the news to my soon-to-be ex-mother-in-law, I bet you thought I was going for a wife again, D, and her daughter, was the most stressful of the day, and after it was done, I was able to relax and feel unbelievably happy and free. While I was speaking with her mother, she phoned and texted me twice, saying things like, "You should not have handled things in that manner. We need to speak about it, and we can't do it in front of our pals. If you're not paying attention, this seems to be standard manipulative conduct." I immediately banned her phone, but she continued to contact me. It took her roughly 20 rejected, blocked calls before she decided to call it quits for the day. She ultimately sent me messages on other applications, but since I didn't check them, it seemed to her that I didn't see them. She contacted my best buddy, but he didn't answer. He finally texted her, saying he didn't want to be involved in our difficulties and asking her to leave him alone. She also phoned my mother, who she had never contacted in the long over 10 years we'd been together, but she didn't answer. We, my mother and sister, had a wonderful drive back home, and after dinner, I invited my friends over and told them everything that had occurred, and they were once again quite supportive. We, my friends and I, went to the wedding the next day, and it was fantastic. Going alone without the cheater was the wisest choice. I had some difficult moments. Seeing the bride and groom's respect and love for each other was especially difficult because I hadn't seen any of that in the previous years, but my friends were incredible and always stood by my side and helped me put all that behind me and enjoy the party. Which I did. The following day, we had lunch with the newlyweds, which was fantastic. Back at home, we celebrated my mother's birthday with a meal with virtually all of my close family members who live nearby, about 20 people. And I used the chance to tell them what had occurred and that I was better today than I had been in the previous months/year. I wanted them to hear it from me, not from someone else. That bomb choked everyone except my mother, father, and sister, who already knew the story and knew I wanted to tell everyone and totally backed me. But after chatting a little more with each one, they could see I was very excellent, and it drew all of us closer together. It was fantastic that everyone was so supportive. Throughout the weekend, my soon-to-be ex-wife attempted to phone me, 30 times and counting, and sent additional messages through messaging applications. In one of the messages, she told me that a life together can't be undone just because I decided to. That she didn't want to fight but only wanted to talk with me. And asked if I was persuaded to leave by a former female coworker and if I was living with her. I'm no expert, but I'd say this is another classic sign of manipulation and projection. She's projecting her cheating behavior on me. That's when I decided to ban her on that chat app. She attempted to contact some of my other friends, but they would not respond and texted her not to involve them in our problems. It's incredible how supportive they are and how they have my back on this. Today, I spent some time with my old colleagues from my prior field of work, and it felt nice to reconnect with those folks with whom I had lost touch, and it's something I want to continue doing. I want to utilize this opportunity to tie up some loose ends, reconnect with people, stop suppressing my feelings, and resolve outstanding problems that led to my falling into the trap of a master manipulator who exploited all of that, as well as my fears, against me. As you can see, the previous several days have been both intense and rewarding. I actually like myself, and my mind is clear. I have no reservations about leaving this dead relationship, and I have no regrets. The divorce will be started this week by the lawyer. I can't wait to be divorced and be rid of that person. Thank you so much for your incredible support. I'm moved by all of your letters and apologies for not replying, something I intend to rectify in the coming days. Your love and strength were crucial in getting through this. From the bottom of my heart, I thank you all. Update 3. This month, I got the chance to meet new individuals as well as reconnect with former colleagues from my previous firm and field of work. It was wonderful to see them again. I had my ups and downs, but thankfully the downs were just 3 very horrible days when I felt wretched and lost at the end of the day. And one of those days I found myself weeping while stopped in traffic. My pals were always there for me and didn't mind my random bursts of texts and slash or phone calls merely to release my emotional roller coaster. One particularly memorable experience was a 30-minute conversation with a young female researcher at my city's university at an event designed to enhance public awareness of the value of scientific research in society. She was a fantastic communicator, as well as intelligent, enthusiastic about her work, a good listener, and very gorgeous. Those 30 minutes spent conversing with her about what she was investigating and the ramifications for society were wonderful. I lost count of time while conversing with her, and the experience fueled me for a whole week. It's both ridiculous and incredible how only a few minutes can improve someone's attitude for so long. And it all occurred because I battled myself to leave the home and go to this event, where I began conversing with complete strangers who were there to present their work and discuss about it. So, my advice to myself and others is to get out of your shell, go places, interact with others, and try new things. If you don't go there, you'll never know what's around the corner. Now for my SDBX cheating. I visited with my lawyer a week after I left her and provided him all the information he needed to complete the divorce proceedings. He recommended me to unblock my SDBX and call her just to inform her that I had hired a lawyer to begin the divorce process and that he would contact her. He also encouraged me not to inform her that I had discovered her cheating on me. When I phoned her that day, She told me I didn't need a lawyer because she didn't want to be with someone who didn't want to be with her, and all I needed to do was tell her I wanted to leave. She went on, essentially criticizing me for leaving and not attempting to solve things, while conveniently failing to mention that she had been regularly banging her coworker in the last year. I couldn't believe she was capable of uttering things like that. It was almost as though she really believed them and that her affair did not exist. If I hadn't gathered any proof before leaving, I would have been questioning myself and would have probably ended up believing in her. I maintained my calm and just answered that I didn't want to discuss what had occurred right now, and that my choice to leave was definitive and not up to argument. This was a stark reminder of the influence that manipulators may have over others, especially if they have poor self-esteem or lack confidence in themselves, which in my case were true, and I believe could be the case for most people stuck in a DB or other unhealthy relationships. This also demonstrated that my decision to simply leave without confronting her was the best one, because at the time I lacked the mental fortitude to keep a cool head and resist her blame shifting and would have ended up A, doing something stupid, or B, staying and becoming even more entangled in her web of manipulations. I met with my lawyer again a few weeks later to sign the paperwork he had prepared. My SDBX had previously met him and signed them, and she informed me that he had asked her if she knew why I wanted to divorce her, and if she didn't, anything I may find improper and might be the reason for the divorce. When she replied that there was nothing she could have done to make me want to leave her, he informed me she was definitely lying. The divorce proceedings have begun and it is hoped that they will be concluded by next Thursday. She didn't object to the divorce and hasn't caused any complications so far, which has really aided things progressing so quickly. My lawyer initially predicted that the divorce would take a few months to complete, so when I received a call from the government agency that handles weddings and divorces saying that it will be finalized next Thursday, I was overjoyed. We'll both meet with the person in charge of the procedure, I'm not sure what the exact English term is, and sign the final paperwork that declares us divorced. This will be the first time I'll see her since I left her. I intend to face her when the divorce is official. I'll also phone her mother and set up a meeting with her parents to confront them if they were already aware of the affair and to explain them my version of events. This may seem counterintuitive to many, but it is something I must do in order to complete this chapter of my life. I'm also considering phoning the other man to thank him for exposing my SDBX's real colors and to inform him that, despite their vow to always be loyal to each other no matter what, she lied to him about a few things. If he agrees to meet with me, I believe I will do so in order to discover from him how and when our connection began, as well as what she told him about it. I'm going to phone a couple of her pals and tell them she used their identities to hide her infidelity with the other man. Then I believe I'm ready to conclude this chapter and move on. Thank you so much for your help. Edit 1, it's finished. We are now legally separated. When we were outside the building, I informed her I knew what she'd been up to with the other man and wished her happiness. She responded that she had no idea what was going on with them and that she was simply doing it to elicit a response from me. I'm guessing she believes it means texting and calling the other person. I also warned her that she would soon discover that people are not loyal to cheats and deceivers. I also phoned her mother and set up a meeting at a nearby mall to explain my side of the story. Thank you for your encouragement and tough remarks. Edit 2. I met with her parents at a nearby mall and gave them my side of the story, which is essentially what's on the original thread but heavily censored. My lawyer urged me not to tell them about the text between them. However, I informed them about certain things I discovered via their communications, as if I had obtained them from other sources, neighbors, friends of mine at her workplace. Their first reaction was to attack me, questioning why I didn't confront her when I found out, why I left without first speaking with her, why I didn't tell them so they could do something. I have no idea what they were thinking, why I left her on the eve of our friend's wedding, and why I hadn't talked with her several months ago. I told them that I needed to take care of myself first, and that if I challenged her, I would be devastated, brainwashed, and guilted into remaining, and that from past discussions we had, I knew she would reject all my worries and brainwash me again. They were calmer after that, and we resumed our usual conversation. They were horrified and couldn't believe she could cheat on me and have an affair behind my back. It's not shocking, and I expected it. At this time, I was debating whether to show them photographs of communications in which she gave him photos of herself in underwear, but I opted against it since my lawyer had advised me not to. They said that she merely informed them that we were scheduled to go to a friend's wedding and that I simply vanished without explanation. They told me she told them the other guy was just a work friend who had some serious problems at home because his mother has Alzheimer's, which is incorrect. She has bipolar disorder, and that he needed to talk about it sometimes, which is why they talked and messaged each other so frequently and at odd hours of the day. Her father also informed me that occasionally women do things like chat to other males in order to provoke a response from their boyfriend, which I found interesting, which is something she also told me. You can read it in Edit 1. Is it just me that thinks this reasoning is flawed? I can only assume that this approach to problem-solving runs in the family. They told me they'd confront her with what I'd told them and see whether her response would reveal whether or not she had cheated on me. I'm sure I'll receive a furious phone call from her soon. I don't care whether or not they believe me. I did what I believed was necessary. They now understand why I departed in the manner that I did. It is not my responsibility what they do with such information. When she's discovered lying again in the future, they won't be able to claim we had no idea. Thank you very much.